It would be nice to introduce Wieniawski, my great spiritual teacher, when I will walk on stage, because, you know, the fact is that Wieniawski was a teacher here in the conservatory for 3 years. He was invited by a great musician, the past Russian musician, Anton Rubinstein. Hendrik Wieniawski was born on 10th of July, 1835, in Poland, into a very famous musical family. He began learning violin at the age of 5, and 3 years later was admitted to the Paris Conservatory, where he began to compose. He embarked on a series of exhausting concert tours, winning huge fame for his virtuosity. He was often regarded as being another devilish Paganini. The original theme and variations are filled with beautiful melodies, acrobatic variations for violinist. He's like, he has to be like in a circus, jumping up and down, and very dangerously accompanied by my wonderful pianist, Ian Brown.
Thank you. Thank you.
The Polonaise Brilliant tells us very interesting stories about Poland. At first, Polonaise were played after the successful war and conquering the lands were parading through the cities. That was in 15th century. Now, in 17th century, Polonaise became more of a noble dance. Everybody had to come into the castle, meet the queen, bow to her, and let the others to come in. And then music would be kind of like a supplement to the beautiful atmosphere.
Thank you.
Kreisler was born in Vienna in 1875, where he attended the conservatory. At the age of 14, he toured the United States for the first time. His brilliant technique brought him recognition as one of the most accomplished violinists of his time, but he withdrew from music several times to study medicine and art, and even to serve as an officer in the Austrian army. This lovely Liebesfreude, which means the happiness of love, brings us to this wonderful Vienna tradition where the waltzes were played. I myself enjoy playing this tremendously because it really brings me to a different world, a world of Kreisler, world of elegance and beauty. Thank you. Here's another piece by Henryk Wieniawski, his very famous Scherzo Tarantella. It's famous for its dramatic character, very dancing flavor, and in a way, Tarantella has a double meaning. First of all, of course, the dance. The second one is Tarantella is like a little bug that always ending up on your shoulder somewhere, so you want to take it away. So that creates a very devilish effect. Thank you. Sergei Vasilievich Rachmaninov was born in 1873 near the Russian city Novgorod. He was representing a wonderful romantic era of composers and pianists. For me, he is like a musical role model, because he wasn't just the greatest pianist of all times, but also a fantastic composer, conductor, and teacher.
Thank you. in Russia, usually comes a lady who is trained and has a very trained voice to announce pieces. So she comes and in a very official manner she, you know, declares Tchaikovsky concerto or Beethoven sonata is played by the musician and that, you know, whoever it is. Now, I'm going to come up with a very unexpected concept here today, and maybe very unusual for Russian audience, so I don't know how it's going to work.
Крестер с Рахманиновым очень часто играли в дуэте. Вот они подготавливают программу к Карнеги Холлу в Америке, в Нью-Йорке. В общем, они порешили, чтобы порешили на том, чтобы играть концерт без репетиции. Вот они встречаются, играют, идет концерт, и вдруг Крейслер забывает музыку. Просто потерял ноты. Он поворачивается к Рахманинову и говорит: «Сергей, где мы?» Рахманинов продолжает играть и говорит: «В Карнеги-холле».
After the revolution in 1917, Rachmaninoff settled in the United States. For many years, Rachmaninoff almost didn't write anything. After that, followed his miracle piece, Rhapsody, on the theme of Paganini. The 18th variation from this Rhapsody, which was transcribed by Fritz Kreisler, combines three beautiful worlds: Paganini, Rachmaninoff, and Kreisler, three of my most favorite composers. Thank you. Niccolò Paganini was born in Genova in 1782. His prodigious ability was soon noticed, and he began touring at a very young age. He met Liszt in Paris and inspired him to develop his piano technique. Paganini was double-jointed and could perform complex works using only one of the four strings of the violin, often having filed down the other strings so that they would break during the performance. Here is a piece by Paganini in a much more romantic and lyrical mood. It is a song, cantabile, but one without words. Eugène Ysaÿe was born in Belgium, in Liège, in 1858. His musical fathers were two mentors, themselves also legendary violinists, Henryk Wieniawski and Henri Vietin. Ysaÿe met and became friends with César Franck, who wrote his celebrated violin sonata for him in 1886. Many violinists, and myself of course, have regarded Ysaÿe as the greatest violinist of all times. This charming caprice, étude en forme de valse, proves that Eugène Ysaÿe was also a fantastic composer. Here he displays an incredible range of virtuosity combined with fantastic chamber music. It's very demanding for violinist, also for the pianist.